I have got with me today the latest M5 iPad Pro. And what's the first thing you do when you get a new iPad Pro? Well, you unbox it. Alright, once you have unboxed the iPad Pro, it's time to set up and activate your iPad Pro. And how do you do that? Well, that's what we are going to learn in today's video. Hey guys, it's Rahul here from TechReview Pro, and today I'm going to show you how you can set up and activate your new iPad Pro. So without any further delay, let's get started and learn how you can set up and activate your new iPad Pro. As soon as you get your iPad Pro out of the box, what you have to do is you have to simply press the power button that you can see here. You have to just long press on this, and after that the iPad Pro will start. You can see the logo glowing here, and it'll just start. And once it starts, all you have to do is you have to just swipe up, and after that you get the option to select the language and region here. First we will select the language, which is English in my case, and I'll set the region to India. And after that it'll just set up the language and region on this iPad. Next, it'll ask you to set up the appearance the way you would like, whether you want to keep the appearance for text as small, default, or medium, or large. And as you select each of these, you will also get a preview of how it would look like. I'll go with the default one and simply tap continue. But in your case, if you want, you can select any other options as well. And once you select continue, you will notice that it'll show you a interface where it'll allow you to quickly set up your iPad. For that, it'll just use the Bluetooth functionality and scan any nearby iPad that you can bring here to set it up from your previous iPad. And by the way, not just iPad, you can also use your iPhone to set it up on your iPad. So if this is your first iPad and you don't have any older iPad to bring your data from that, then you don't have to worry, because you can simply use your iPhone to set up your iPad as well from your iPhone. I'll show you how to do that, but first, let me show you on my iPad. And if I just bring it nearby, I'll press the power button, and you will notice that here it will show setup new iPad. So you can simply unlock and set it up from this iPad to this one. But I'm not going to do that right now. I'll just use my iPhone to set it up on iPad so that everyone can learn and set up and activate their iPad. As you can see here, I have already got a pop-up here on my iPhone. If you don't see the pop-up, you will have to ensure that you have unlocked your iPhone. And once you have unlocked your iPhone and bring it nearby the iPad, you'll get this pop-up. After that, what you have to do is you have to just unlock and continue. And once you tap on continue, it'll just show you something like this. All you have to do is you have to just bring this image into this frame on iPhone. So you can see the frame of iPhone camera here. We will hold it like this and bring it inside. And once you bring that inside the frame, you will notice that it'll just get started with the setting up, and your iPad will just start syncing with your iPhone. Now everything is on-screen instructions, and as you can see, it is showing here that continue on your iPhone and keep this iPad near your iPhone while setting up. So we will just keep it nearby both devices and continue on this one. You can see here I'm getting the setup new iPad, and I'll just ensure that I'm using the right Apple ID to set it up. So in this case, I'm okay with this Apple ID, which is my existing Apple ID. So I'll just tap on setup for me and then enter the passcode here. Let's enter the passcode. And as I just entered the passcode, you will notice that the iPad is being set up and activated. Now it is activating, and you can see it is showing it may take a few minutes to activate on your iPad. That means we will just have to wait for a few seconds or minutes as well in some cases, and after that the iPad will activate. And once activated, we will continue with the setup. And by the way, it is worth noting that as the setup and activation process is going on, you don't have to remove your iPhone from here. You have to just keep the iPhone or iPad from where you are setting up the new iPad. Keep that device nearby as long as the setup continues. And after that, I'm getting this option to update the software, but I'm not going to do that right now. I'll simply tap update later, and then I'll get the data and privacy message. Here I can tap continue and simply agree with the data and privacy terms. After that, you'll get the option to set up Face ID. Since this iPad Pro is having the Face ID functionality, so I'll set up Face ID as well. But if you don't have Face ID functionality on your iPad, you can skip this process and continue with the future ones. So I'll simply tap continue, and after that, it is saying me to rotate the iPad to landscape so that the Face ID can be set up. So I'll rotate it like this, and after that, here I get the option to set up Face ID. I'll tap get started, and then a camera will appear here. So I'll just move my face inside the frame, and I'll move it round like this, and after that you'll get this message that first Face ID scan is complete. Now you will have to tap on continue and continue with setting up Face ID, which is the second scan. So tap continue, and now move your head slowly like this and let the scan complete. And once the second Face ID scan is complete, you will see this message that Face ID setup is now complete. Now tap continue, and then it will just set up your account. And after that, you'll get this pop-up for transferring your apps and data. Here you'll have to select and decide from where you want to transfer your apps and data on your iPad. Now it is worth noting that selecting the right selection here is pretty important. If you just want to set up this iPad as a new iPad without transferring any data or apps, you'll simply select the option that says don't transfer anything. And there are other options as well. So you can see it is from Android. So if you are going to transfer your apps and data from an Android phone, you can select this one as well. And the next one is from Mac or PC. And that just explains itself. If you are going to transfer your data from Mac or any Windows PC, you will select this option. And if you want to transfer it from another iPad, then you will select this option, which is from another iPad. And finally, there is from iCloud Backup. So if you have already got an iCloud account or Apple ID and you just backup your data on iCloud, you can select this option and then log in with your Apple ID or iCloud account here. And once you are logged in, you will get the option to select which iCloud backup you want to recover. So select the one according to your preference and continue with the on-screen instructions to restore the iCloud backup on your iPad. But I'll just go back and set it up as a new iPad. For that, I'll select don't transfer anything, and then it'll ask me to sign into Apple ID. At this point, you can either sign into your Apple ID and continue with that, and if you don't have an Apple ID, you can simply tap on this option, which is forgot password or don't have an account, and then continue with creating a new free Apple ID account by tapping on this option. So it's pretty easy to set up your iPad even if you don't have an Apple account earlier and you are just first time Apple device user. And in case you have already got any of the Apple devices, then you also get the options to select those options and get your data on your iPad from those devices. But I prefer setting up Apple ID later in settings, and you can do that as well, because in that situation, you don't have to waste any time in creating Apple ID or signing into Apple ID. And you can also do that later as well. So just go with this option to set up later in settings, and then confirm that you don't want to use Apple ID right now. And it'll just proceed with the setup. And next, you'll have to agree to the terms and conditions. So if you have time, you can simply read all of these text for terms and conditions, but I don't have so much time, so I'll just continue with agree. And after that, confirm by tapping agree again. And then it'll just proceed to the next step, where it'll ask what apps and data and settings I want to bring it on this iPad. Here you can tap continue to continue with the preferences and settings that Apple wants you to keep on your iPad. But I don't want to do that because I don't want to automatically update my iPad software and all that. So I'll just tap customize and go with my on selection. Here you'll see that it is asking whether I want to update iPad automatically or not. I'll prefer not to update my iPad automatically. So I'll select only download automatically. That way it'll just download the updates, but it'll not install itself. And I'll have the full control to install it myself. Further, it'll ask for permissions for location services. You can either turn on location services or set up later. For various apps and features like maps, you'll have to allow the access for location services. So you can turn on location services and then you can decide whether you want to turn on screen time or not. Screen time is basically a way to track the screen time on your iPad. So if you spend time on your iPad, it will just track how much time you are spending on which apps. And depending upon the screen time report, you can decide which one to focus on and which one to cut down. So you can turn on this as well. And at any time, if you want to set it up later, you can select this option as well. I'll go with continue because I want to let my iPad track my screen time. Further, it will ask for iPad analytics. So you can help Apple improve its products and services by sending the reports for the data and usage on your iPad. And this data is sent in an anonymous way, so your privacy is not at risk. So you can share the analytics with Apple and tap on this option. But I don't want to share that, so I'll tap don't share. Next, you can decide whether you want to keep the display light or dark. So if you select light mode, it'll show the light mode on your iPad like this. Or if you select dark mode, it'll show like this. I prefer to keep it auto so that it'll automatically adjust depending upon whether it is daytime or nighttime in my environment. And after that, tap continue. Next, it'll ask whether you want to set up Apple Intelligence or not. So if you want to use Apple Intelligence on your iPad, you can tap on Setup Apple Intelligence. Further, it'll ask to set up Siri as well. I won't set up Siri right now on this iPad, so I'll set up later. And then it'll ask whether I want to enroll in Apple beta software program or not. If you are a developer and want to test the beta software, you can continue with that. But I'll go with don't continue beta program. And after that, confirm again to don't continue Apple beta program. And further, you'll get the option to select the multitasking and windowing. You'll also get a preview here that how it would look like. You'll see the full screen apps like this or full screen and windowed apps like this. So depending upon your preference, you can select any of these and tap continue. And after that, your iPad is ready to use. So setup is complete and I can see the welcome screen here. I'll just tap get started and now the iPad is ready. So this is how you set up your new iPad.